Fukuchiyama, Kyoto. Hori Yasuemon is a maker of Noh masks. First, he uses a chisel to rough out the face from a block of wood. Noh masks are usually made from hinoki, a type of cypress. Hinoki is easy to work and resists warping. Before it's carved, the wood is dried thoroughly. This takes years. A Noh mask must be able to express a subtle shift in a character's frame of mind. For this, the eyes are crucial. The surface of the eyes and the pupils are carved deep. The upper and lower eyelids protrude. Thicker eyelids deepen the shadows falling on the eyes. Then it's easier to make the face look happy from one angle and sad from another. If the carver makes even the slightest error, the expression of the mask may be irreversibly altered. A skillful craftsman can breathe life into a mask. After the mask has been shaped, color is applied. One difficult task is to strike the right balance between the black lines of the eyes and hair and the pale tone of the skin. To achieve a deep black, India ink is mixed with aged soot. The red of the lipstick is given a tinge of blue to help the lips blend with the surrounding skin. Once a color has been applied, it's scraped with a bamboo tool, then applied again. This makes the color look more natural. The skin tone is created by applying several coats of paint over a period of a week. The pigments have been aged for 3 or 4 years and have soot added to them. This helps to create a color with depth. The maker of the Noh mask uses a variety of traditional techniques to endow the mask with the power to reflect subtle shades of human emotion. One moment brimming with anticipation, the next shy and self-conscious.
This time I've come to a neighborhood called Higashiyama, which is well known for its antique shops. But I've actually come to visit a lady who makes Noh masks, who lives in this house here. So let's go straight in. Hello.
These are male masks on this side here and female masks on that side. You can tell them apart by looking at their hair. Female masks have their hair parted in the middle. These look very similar, but there are subtle differences. For instance, this is a girl 15 or 16 years old. And this one, a young woman between about 20 and 22 years old. And here, about the same age, but this one is a goddess. The lips are a little different. The lips on the other mask make her seem like she's smiling, but not so much on this mask here. This one's called Yamamba. She's an ogress who lives in the mountains. She's not a human being, so she has metal fittings in the eyes. And this is a Hanya mask. It represents a jealous female demon. A woman was so jealous, her face became like this.
I mean, they're all very realistic. This one particularly almost looks like he's alive.
This is Yaseotoko, an emaciated man. He's the ghost of someone who died with an unresolved grudge.
Depending on the angle you look at them from, they do really have very different expressions. This man here looks quite different.
Yes, it will vary depending on the angle.
If you say in Japanese that someone has a face like a Noh mask, it means that they're expressionless, but the expression really is down to the skill of the actor wearing the mask.